Hello, this is Dr. Glasbrenner from George Mason University, and in this video, we will learn how to use the infer package to simulate the gender discrimination experiment and conduct a hypothesis test. If you would like to follow along with the examples shown in this lecture, you can load the dataset directly from the internet by placing the following setup code block at the top of a new R Markdown file. This will load the tidyverse and infer packages, load the gender discrimination dataset directly from data.cds101.com, and store the experimental difference in proportions in the variable experiment underscore result. Let's recap the details of the gender discrimination experiment to remind ourselves of what we will try to establish over the next few slides. The gender discrimination study was a scientific experiment involving 48 male bank supervisors that were each given the same personnel file and asked the judge whether the person should be promoted to a branch manager job that was described as routine. The files were identical, except that half of the supervisors had files showing that the person was male, while the other half had files showing that the person was female. It was randomly determined which supervisors got male applications and which got female applications. The key result for the experiment was that 29.2% more men than women were recommended for promotion. The key question for this case study is whether or not this result is statistically significant. A formal analysis of whether or not the result is statistically significant requires that we perform a hypothesis test. The null hypothesis for this experiment is that promotion and gender are independent, there is no gender discrimination, and any observed difference in proportions is simply due to chance. The alternative hypothesis for this experiment is that promotion and gender are dependent, men are more likely to be promoted than women due to gender discrimination, and the observed difference in proportions is not due to chance. We need to generate a null distribution in order to perform a hypothesis test. In a previous video, we saw how to do this using a deck of playing cards. Now we will do the same thing using R using the infer package. The code block shows how you would generate the null distribution for this dataset. As you can see, there are four functions that we use: specify, hypothesize, generate, and calculate. Every time you generate a null distribution, you will use these four commands in this order. The only thing that changes are the input parameters. Let's step through this code one line at a time. We begin by piping the dataset into the specify function, which in this example requires two inputs. The first input is where you specify the response variable and the explanatory variable. The relationship between the response and explanatory variables is written using a special formula syntax, outcome tilde sex. The words outcome and sex are the names of columns in the dataset. The word on the left side of the tilde, outcome in this example, is the response variable. The word on the right side of the tilde, sex in this example, is the explanatory variable. Figuring out which variable goes where requires you to know which quantity was being measured and which quantity was varied. The second input, success equals promoted, is used when the response column contains categorical variables. The word promoted is one of the two categories listed under this column. This input indicates that a value of promoted will be counted as a success. This is why, in the playing card demo, we only needed to count promotions of men and women. Next, we pipe into the hypothesize function, which in this example only has one input. The null equals independence means that we will generate the null distribution by assuming that the outcome and sex columns are independent of one another. Generally, if both your response variable and explanatory variable in the specify function reference column names in your dataset, you can expect to use null equals independence. Next, we pipe into the generate function. The first input, repos equals 10,000, means that we will run 10,000 simulations to generate our null distribution. The second input, type equals permute, means that each simulation will consist of randomly shuffling the order of the cells in the outcome column and the sex column. Each column is shuffled separately, which in principle breaks any meaningful connection between the two. For the last step, we pipe into the calculate function. The first input, stat equals diffinprops, is where we specify what exactly it is that we're calculating. This must mirror how the observed experimental result was calculated. The observed experimental result was calculated by subtracting the fraction of promoted men from the fraction of promoted women. In other words, by taking the difference in proportions, which is what diffinprops means. The second input, order equals combine male, comma female, specifies the order of the subtraction. This means that the fraction of promoted men will come before the minus sign, and the fraction of promoted women will come after the minus sign. The words male and female are categories under the sex column. Finally, it is important to be aware that it will take several seconds to run 10,000 simulations. You might think that our studio froze, but unless there's an error somewhere, it's just that this is a more heavy-duty calculation compared to what we've encountered so far in the class. The infer package provides us with a couple of handy convenience functions for visualizing the null distribution and comparing it to the observed experimental result. We pipe our null distribution into the function visualize, which sets up a ggplot2 visualization for us. We are still free to add some extra details to the plot in the usual way. The function shade_p_value can be used to add a line representing the observed experimental result, which we set using obs_stat=experiment_result. The input direction=right shades the region of the null distribution with outcomes that are more extreme than experiment, which are simulations where we found that an even greater number of men were promoted over women. From looking at this distribution, we can see that, just like in the playing card simulation, the difference in proportions observed in experiment is not a common result. In fact, that shaded red region is how we quantify how likely it is that a random chance model would generate our observed experimental result. The shaded region is related to the probability that a simulated experiment generates an outcome that is the same or more extreme than the experiment. This is not difficult to calculate. All we need to do is count how many simulations gave us a result that was the same or more extreme than experiment, and then divide by 10,000, which is the total number of simulations. We can do this computation manually using filter and summarize, which tells us that 2.27% of our simulations were the same or more extreme. This value we just computed is called the p-value, and the infer package provides us with a convenience function, get_p_value, for calculating p-values so that we don't have to do it manually. The inputs for get_p_value match shade_p_value from the previous slide. obs_stat=experiment_result is where we input the observed experimental result, and direction=right says that, when computing the p-value, we only count simulation results with outcomes greater than or equal to obs_stat. Having established that 97.7% of our simulations based on a random chance model produced experimental outcomes less extreme than our experimental results, we can now adequately address the question, do the results of the simulation provide convincing evidence of gender discrimination against women, i.e., dependence between gender and promotion decisions? There are two possible conclusions to choose from. The first option is no. The data do not provide convincing evidence for the alternative hypothesis. Therefore, we can't reject the null hypothesis of independence between gender and promotion decisions. The observed difference between the two proportions was due to chance. And the second option is yes, the data provide convincing evidence for us to reject the null hypothesis in favor of the alternative hypothesis of gender discrimination against women in promotion decisions. The observed difference between the two proportions was due to a real effect of gender. Based on our analysis, option 2 should be our conclusion.